Hey guys, it's Bethany here and welcome to another video. Today we're going to be taking a quick look back at some of the books that I loved the most over 2020. I feel like I really struck gold this year. There for a while I was having kind of trouble finding the will to read. I was mainly listening to audiobooks, which there's nothing wrong with. Of course, I still listen to audiobooks. But I was hitting about one book a month, usually an audiobook with my Audible subscription. And when spring rolled around of this year, I just knew I wanted to do more. So without further ado, here are some of my favorite books that I have read so far in 2020. First up, we'll start with Becoming by Michelle Obama. This has raving reviews, so there's no surprise that I enjoyed it immensely. She goes over her life, what it was like to live in the White House, be wife to the president, as well as have her own career, her own education, and raise two children. I knew that I liked Michelle Obama, but I didn't realize how much I would like her whenever I finished this, and I highly recommend it if you are into memoirs and just want to learn more about her life. Another nonfiction book that I really liked was Killers of the Flower Moon by David Gran. This one is a true crime novel about real life events in Oklahoma. I grew up in Oklahoma, and this book, the majority of it, took place not even 30 minutes from where I grew up. And surprisingly, I didn't even know the history of what happened. I had no idea the history of the Osage murders, the injustices brought upon those of the Osage tribe during the 20s and the 30s. And this book also goes into a little bit of the FBI, how it got started, and some of the first cases that had to do with the Osage murders and the beginning of the FBI. If you like true crime, this is definitely a great book. I do have a little bit of a worry that I was so invested in this book because it did take place in my home state, but I still think it's an amazing book and it has great ratings. You'll probably like it too. Moving on to a classic, we have Brave New World. Moving on to a classic, we have Brave New World by Aldous Huxley. This one was definitely a book that I got in college and probably didn't actually read because I had zero memory of the plot. It's meant as a satire for a utopian future. It takes place mainly in what was London, but has evolved into a completely different world. And in this utopian future, they heavily genetically select the exact traits that they want for the humans that they are birthing in pods. Give you kind of that like Matrix vibe. But they also use classical psychological training to keep everyone in their roles in society and keep them passive. And even though this was written in 1932, it honestly feels like it could have been written in recent years. It stays very current. So if you're looking for a classic read that isn't too much of a bore, I do recommend Brave New World. A reread that I had this year was The Fault in Our Stars by John Green. I think we all know what this book is about by this point. And it does have a movie adaptation, so even if you haven't read the book, you've probably seen the movie. They're fairly similar in plot, and I read this book during a readathon in July. I really love John and Hank Green. Those brothers are hilarious. They're fantastic, kind human beings. So if you don't know about their YouTube channel, The Vlog Brothers, definitely check it out. Another YA novel that I read and really enjoyed, but is actually new to me this year, is With the Fire on High by Elizabeth Acevedo. In this one, we follow Imoni. I actually haven't heard it said out loud, so I don't know exactly how to pronounce it. I'm terrible at pronouncing names, but I think it's Imoni. Correct me if I'm wrong, please. But Imoni is in high school still. She has a little girl that she had as a teenager, and she has the miraculous ability to put thoughts and emotions into the food that she creates for other people and cooks. So all she wants to do is become a chef, and she is trying to work through life being a teenage mom and going to high school, as well as attempting to find a path through life that she really wants. Highly recommend if you are into YA. And another one, I think I read quite a bit of YA. I hadn't in a very long time, so once I started back up again, I couldn't stop this year. And I just happen to be picking some very good ones. Speaking of some very good ones, we have A Good Girl's Guide to Murder by Holly Jackson. And in this one, I think her full name is Piper, so I wanna say it's Pipe, but she is trying to solve the murder of a girl in her town and help clear the name of the boy who was said to have murdered her. This was my first dive back into the murder thriller world this year, and I really enjoyed the story. I thought it was unique, original, and I felt it was mostly realistic in what a teenager would be able to accomplish. There were a couple times they jumped to conclusions and led her to some information I don't think she probably would have been able to find on herself, But still, it was very good, especially for YA mystery, and I highly recommend it. Moving on to some adult fiction now, we've got The Vanishing Half by Britt Bennett. And this one has been extremely popular this year, so I won't go too much into the plot. But basically, we have two sisters living in a town in Louisiana who have essentially tried to make their skin as light as possible. It was founded by a man who valued light skin, who was a darker skinned person. And through the years, those black members of the community have lightened their skin so they almost appear white. Two sisters are growing up, twins, and they look exactly the same as twins do. One sister decides to go in the world and pretend that she is a white woman, and the other stays within the black community. I really enjoyed this one. I wouldn't say it is that 5 out of 5 stars for me that everyone else has been giving it, but it was extremely well done. I love how beautiful the writing is, and the character development was excellent. Another great mystery slash thriller that I read this year was A Good Marriage by Kimberly McCrite. Sorry, Kimberly. And this one is about Lizzie. She is a relatively new lawyer in New York City when she randomly receives a call from a friend from college who is in jail and was accused of murdering his wife. The book goes back and forth between Lizzie's point of view as well as Amanda, the murdered wife. And you see her leading up to the days of the murder, and you get the backstory slowly as you move through. I thought this was a really well done mystery, and I guessed some of the ending, but not all of it. One portion of it actually surprised and I like gasped out loud. So if you're looking for a very good mystery thriller from this year, check out A Good Marriage. A really touching book that I read that I enjoyed immensely during my readathon during July was The Stars in the Blackness Between Us by Junauda Petros. This one is also YA, but it deals with some pretty heavy themes. And in it, we follow Audrey, who is coming from her home island of Trinidad to the States to live with her father. She's not very happy about it. Some unfortunate events have led to her coming there. But she quickly meets a new friend, Mabel, and they have a very sweet friendship, and you learn a lot about their lives, their past, what makes them tick. And really honestly, in the end, I cried. It was wonderful. If you like The Fault in Our Stars, this book is relatively similar, just with an LGBT spin on that situation, as well as bringing in the black experience into that situation. Okay, now we're gonna quickly move on to some audiobooks or digital books that I don't have physical copies of, but I'll put right here. The first of those is A Curse So Dark and Lonely by Bridget Kemmerer, as well as a sequel, A Heart So Fierce and Broken, that came out earlier this year. I loved both of those. They are Beauty and the Beast retellings, and that is one of my favorite Disney movies of all time, but it has a modern day twist on it. And the second one is quite a bit different from the first one. It takes place from different characters' viewpoints, and I had wished we had stayed with a couple of the characters a little bit more in the second than we did in the first, but both were excellent, and you should definitely check them out if you like YA retellings. Next up, we have The Seven Husbands of Evelyn Hugo by Taylor Jenkins Reid. This one has been talked about all year since I've joined Bookstagram, and it had some pretty steep expectations to live up to. I listened to the book, which I think was a really smart choice. I loved the narrator. And we follow Evelyn Hugo in her life as a Hollywood actress, the struggles she went through with her 7 different husbands. And we also get a look into the life of Monique, the reporter who was going to interview Evelyn about her life. It typically gets 4 or 5 stars all around for about everyone who rates it. Though I have seen some people who didn't enjoy it very much, so it seems a very polarizing. You either really love it or you really don't like it. I still definitely recommend it. Another audiobook that I read was Codename Helene by Ariel Lahon. Sorry, Ariel. And it is a fictionalized version of Nancy Wade's life, who was a French spy during World War II. She was actually Australian, a super badass lady, and I hadn't even heard of her before reading this book. I know there are several different fictionalized retellings of her life, though Ariel's version seems to be pretty spot on. She did say that she condensed some events so that they'd be more palatable in the book, but almost every detail actually happened to Nancy. And if you're into historical fiction, definitely check that one out. Another audiobook that I listened to was All Boys Aren't Blue by George M. Johnson. And I don't even know how to explain how much I love this book. It was a memoir of his life, and it detailed him growing up as a gay black youth and some of the hardships he has faced throughout his life, as well as some of the wonderful things that have come from his situation. It was narrated by George himself, so if you enjoy authors narrating in their own words, I can't recommend it enough. There were definitely several more books I could have put on this list, but I'm gonna cut it off right there. I hope you guys enjoyed looking back on my year so far in 2020 of the books that I really loved, and I can't wait to read more and discuss more with you as the year goes on. Like I said, check down below for my Instagram if you enjoy more current and up-to-date reviews, and I'll also link my blog where I'll put a lot of these reviews on there as well. Please subscribe if you enjoyed this video. We have future book content coming for you as well, and check out the other two videos that I have that are book related so far. If you enjoy gaming, I have Sims 4 and Planet Zoo content on my gaming channel, which I'll also link down below. And please like the video so other people can find us. Thank you so much for joining me, and I hope you guys have a wonderful rest of your day. Bye!